The College of Engineering Technology at RIT offers unique master's degree programs in areas pertaining to telecommunications, construction management, environmental health and safety, manufacturing and mechanical systems, packaging science, and print and graphic media science. These are very unique degree programs, not commonly found in other universities.
Our CET faculty have come from industry, and what we do is we bring that knowledge into the classroom as well as into our research. And there really aren't that many universities that have this level of industrial experience in their programs. Our machines here at RIT are state of the art. They can do exactly what's being done in the volume manufacturing of electronics around the world.
One of the facilities I have access to is actually right here at SEMA Lab. We have a full SMT assembly line, and out in the industry, many companies have the same sort of setup, but they're always occupied and don't have the means to do low volume research, which is what we do here at RIT.
There's only a handful of similar labs at universities, and I would argue the one we have here at RIT is the most modern. Students as well as potential industry partners can come into our lab and use it as almost like a prototyping lab.
At CET, I study low temperature solder. For one of my co-op experiences, I worked at a small startup company, and their goal was to validate their own solder paste out in the market. My responsibility was to run experiments, making sure that their specifications meets their customers' expectations.
Most of our graduate students participate in our cooperative education to really get a feel and an understanding for how the industry works.
I think that this opportunity is unlike any other singular degree program in any other college. You're really able to connect the classroom learning with the real life experiences.
They have opportunities to work at Fortune 500 companies like Google or Apple or Amazon. I was at a conference and I was approached by my colleagues asking, do you have any students? Can you send me resumes? How many students are graduating right now? So these jobs exist. And as the baby boomer generation begins to retire, there's actually a huge demand for students that have the skills that we teach here in CET.
The College of Engineering Technology, they purchased a welding robot, and it was pretty old, and I took it upon myself to really figure out how it worked, what was wrong with it, and really get it up to standard. There's obviously not that many resources online for some of these industrial robots, so a lot of what I did consisted of calling different companies and talking to people that had the knowledge, being able to network and really learn about this older technology in ways where we can actually service it and keep it up and running ourselves. I think it's going to be really huge as we go out into the workforce.
The research opportunities within CET are very practical, very hands-on, very industry-focused. So the solutions that you as a student come up with will be implemented right away for the benefit of the industry, and you will be able to see it being implemented.
Here at RIT, my research team is taking a unique approach to a very complicated problem, looking at product development for pediatric nebulizers. You have devices that were designed for adults being used for pediatrics. Pediatrics are not mini adults. So what can we do better than what already exists?
I am working with Dr. O'Neill, working with nebulizers. This is a device that will pump air through it to deliver medicine into the lungs. We're trying to look at the particle sizes and the delivery rate of the medication.
One of the things that I love about my research and working with my students is that we have the ability to make a difference. So by advancing the current state and developing new products, you will have the opportunity to make an impact.
I worked with Dr. O'Neill in my undergrad, and it's been a really awesome experience just getting to know more female engineers on campus, and it's been really rewarding.
I think one of the great opportunities for graduate students is to further explore that question of why. We want our students to interact with the equipment. We want the students to get hands-on, real-world experience. Packaging science is a really unique blend of both the creative, but then also the technical engineering aspects. We frequently work with the College of Science, the College of Art and Design, trying to translate things that are relevant in other areas and bring those into the labs.
We are all good at parts of the problem, and we can make improvements and enhancements by working together. And you would get to be a part of, how do I work with clinicians? How do I work with mathematicians? How do I work with scientists as an engineer?
When I came into communication networks, the field of fiber optics was what really sparked my interest. My main interests are lasers. I went to the College of Science and I spoke with students over there regarding aspects about astronomy, and I also told them about how lasers are used in various astrophysics applications, especially when it comes to things like the James Webb Space Telescope and the LIGO gravitational wave detection. And that's exactly why I'm doing a PhD in electrical and computer engineering as well here at RIT.
The community here within the College of Engineering Technology is definitely a tight-knit group. And this has been really great for me because I was able to develop those connections and relationships early on.
And it's really one of my favorite things about RIT. You're with those people probably close to like 20 to 30 hours a week. So you really are creating friendships and lasting connections that are really never gonna go away.
Like, it's like I've kind of found like a family, and the amount of support that you have and the amount of time that you get to spend with your professors, that has helped me charter a future for myself.
Our graduates from the master's degree programs will be able to solve today's real world problems while being able to understand the technology implementations required for the future.